I talked about the proposition that certain critical infrastructure should be off limits to attack, period, by cyber or any other means. I gave them a list, if I'm not mistaken, I don't have it in front of me, 16 specific entities, 16 defined as critical infrastructure under U.S. policy, from the energy sector to our water system.
Say what?
President Sippy Cup, your president, Joe Biden, probably resting comfortably after his big summit with Vladimir. As predicted, by any objective measure, the meeting was an utter train wreck.
Joe don't know.
How dumb is it to give a hostile actor, an evil guy like Vladimir Putin, 16 specific things, a roadmap that would cripple the USA? That's pretty dumb.
Because even if you're a rank partisan, you see that these meetings require real expertise. Because there are real consequences to being outmaneuvered, which Biden was.
And if you don't know, now you know, nigga.
Putin obviously preferred Trump policy-wise, but there's got to be a small part of him that's relieved not to have to make small talk with Trump anymore in those long one-on-one meetings.
Say what?
In a weekend interview, Vladimir Putin laughed at the suggestion that you had called him a killer. Is that still your belief, sir, that he is a killer?
Well, look, I mean, he has made clear that,
Joe Biden is a dummy.
Even Putin was willing to admit that he was dealing with a more experienced statesman in Biden. Our key allies in the G7 and NATO also seemed excited throughout Biden's trip about the fact that they were finally dealing with a U.S. president interested in global cooperation to solve common problems.
Say what?
Listen to how CNN is reporting this momentous event.
Joe Biden is stepping onto the world stage for the first time as president, an equal to foreign leaders.
Now, let's go back in time to 2018 and see if those same newsrooms offer the presidency of Donald Trump such light and positive coverage.
Dramatic and deepening G7 divide, better put perhaps as G6 versus one.
I just think Joe Biden is a lucky person. He has got all the media on his side, or most of the media on his side, particularly CNN, completely at odds with what they did to Trump. So, you know, his popularity surely can only win from this because he's getting so much positive PR through the journalists who are massive fans of him. It's really quite appalling to watch. And what happened to straight news reporting, which doesn't seem to be existent there?
How are your meetings going in Cornwall, Mr. President? How are your meetings going here in Cornwall?
Corn Pop was a bad dude, and he ran a bunch of bad boys.
Come on.
Say what?
I want to be clear to folks in this region who are thinking about making that dangerous trek to the United States-Mexico border. Do not come.
You don't care if it's wrong or
do not
if
come.
It's right.
I'm gonna come.
Roxanne, you don't have to put on the red.
The United States will continue to enforce our laws and secure our border. There are legal methods by which migration can and should occur. But we, as one of our priorities, will discourage illegal migration. And I believe if you come to our border, you will be turned back.
A new day is coming. We got to get beyond this election.
but that we as a nation are better than this? Because I'm going to tell you, the reason I say all that is that I know how this is going to play out. And I know what's been happening since the beginning when this president was elected, which is these immigrant families have been further pushed into to living underground, to living in the shadows. That's not reflective of the civil society.
I want to be clear to folks in this region who are thinking about making that dangerous trek to the United States-Mexico border. Do not come.
My message to them is do not live in fear. You are not alone, and America's values are such that we do not condone, as an American value, putting children in cages.
The United States will continue to enforce our laws and secure our border. We, as one of our priorities, will discourage illegal migration.
Say what?
What we witnessed was, as we were beginning to assemble the parade, I was walking with Congressman Ted Deutsch, and the parade had just begun. And we saw people lining up, ready to move, and then all of a sudden, this white pickup truck dashed right through the crowd, barely missing Congresswoman Wasserman Schultz's car by inches, and just dashed, cut through, smashed through a gate, smashed into a landscaping company, and he hit two people on the ground.
As it, what does this appear
this
to
was
be?
A terrorist attack against the LGBT community. This is exactly what it is.
You don't think this was an accident?
Hardly an accident. It was deliberate, it was premeditated, and it was targeted against a specific person. Luckily, they missed that person, but unfortunately, they hit two other people, which I think they'll be okay. I don't know. They're laying on the ground right now. We're hoping that they'll survive.
What we saw, it was a terrorist attack on the LGBT community. This is disgusting. We will not stand for this. This is not going to happen in my city or any city.
Well, a good news for him is that that wasn't a terrorist attack. It did not happen in Fort Lauderdale. It did not happen while he was mayor. And of course, this is a horrible tragedy. The fact of the matter is, we now know, even at the time when the young man was taken out of the truck, he was wearing a Gay Men's Chorus t-shirt. He said it was an accident. This is a liberal dynamic where there was no details, and it was immediately declared a terrorist attack. Where do you think that comes from, and is that something even fair to say without knowing all of the details, no matter how sure you are?
No, of course not. I mean, that's something you want to get absolutely correct, right? And of course, the mayor didn't care about that. He didn't care about the facts. He had a narrative to be pushed. And this is emblematic, Tammy, as you pointed out, of a broader problem we have in the country right now. We have an epidemic of false narratives. I mean, look over the past few years. How many false narratives have been told by the people in charge or the media where they want to push a narrative instead of the facts that meets their world view? I mean, we see it with the Covington kids story. We saw it with Russiagate. We even see it with the deadly narrative that's being told now about police brutality in America. It's simply not happening. I mean,
the statement is the weakest walk back I have ever seen for a couple of reasons. One, he says, well, I was terrorized. Well, that's not what you said. You said it was a terrorist attack. And then he goes on to say, you know, we've got problems and this kind of thing shouldn't happen in our town. And you think, wait a minute, you absolutely said these absolute lies. And the fact he said, quoting, it was deliberate. He went on to say it was premeditated and it was targeted against a specific person, meaning Deborah Wasserman Schultz. All of that was false. And the question becomes, you know, you wonder if President Trump were still in office, if he would have went on to say, and all of this is being ginned up by the rhetoric in the Oval Office. That's kind of the pattern that he was going on.
You do a criminal investigation, you have the law enforcement, you have the chief of police speaking. This guy went out and intentionally lied. He lied without any factual information from law enforcement. And he can't walk that back. But the Democrats and the left are always going to play identity politics because they want us to feel oppressed. I do not feel oppressed.